Hello students, in this session let us learn about how to draw the use case diagram. In the last class I told you that UML is basically divided into three parts: things, relationships and diagrams. Things again are divided into structural, behavioral, grouping and annotation. We have four different types of relationships and we have nine different types of diagrams. In today's session we will be talking about how to draw the use case diagram. So what exactly is this use case diagram? Use case diagram is a pictorial representation of the functional requirements from user perspective. Okay, so they actually talk about how different people or systems interact with the software that we have developed. Now let us see what are the various symbols we have in this use case diagram. The first symbol that we have in this use case diagram is the actor. Actor is a person or a system who will be interacting with the software. So the symbol for actor is a stick figure, as you can see here. Okay, sometimes we can give relationship between one actor to the another actor. This is not compulsory, but when one particular actor is having a generalization relationship with another actor, then you can give a relationship. Now what do you mean by generalization? Generalization is one particular actor belonging to another actor. Like for example, you have a vehicle. Car, bus, bike, all these are vehicles. They belong to the vehicle class. Okay, so when you want to give a relationship between vehicle and a car, it is generalization. When you want to give a relationship between vehicle and a bus, it is generalization. So if you find that two actors are having such sort of generalization relationship, you can give a generalization relationship here. So in this example, you have a customer, you have a commercial customer. Commercial customer is a part of a customer. So I have given a generalization relationship here. It is not mandatory to connect two actors. But if you want to connect, make sure it is generalization only. Okay. The next symbol you have is use case. Use case is basically the action that is performed by the actor. Okay. So it is symbolized as a vowel. Inside this vowel, you will be writing what is the action that you are performing. So in this particular example, let's assume that the customer has gone to an ATM center to withdraw the amount. Withdrawing the amount is the use case. Customer is the actor. Right? Now the next symbol you have is a system boundary. The rectangular box that you are seeing here is the system boundary. We use the system boundary to separate actors from the use cases. Use cases will be inside the system boundary. Actors will be outside the system boundary. The next one you have is association. Generally, if you want to give a connection between an actor and a use case, we use this association relationship. Okay, you can use directed association or you can use a normal association, as you can see here. So in this particular example, I have given directed association. In this example, I have given normal association with multiplicity. Now, what do you mean by multiplicity? Multiplicity is nothing but giving one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-many or many-to-one relationship, right? So here in this example, one customer can perform zero withdrawals or a maximum of one withdrawal only. At a time, he can do only one withdrawal. So one-to-one relationship. One bank will handle n number of customers doing withdrawals. So one bank, many withdrawals, one-to-many relationship. This is how you have to give multiplicity in association. Okay. Now, generally, if you want to give a connection between actor and actor, we give generalization. Actor to use case, association. Now, what if I want to give a relationship between use case and use case? In that situation, you can go for either include or extends. What do you mean by include? When one particular action is including another action. In this example, withdrawing of amount is including card identification. So if you are inserting a valid card into the ATM, then only you are allowed to withdraw the amount. So this is include relationship. So in include, the arrow mark goes from the original use case to the included use case. Right? The next one you have is extends. Sometimes an action will be giving us certain options. So let us assume that you are in a cart page and you are placing an order. So the customer is placing an order. So he has options here. He can either apply the discount or he can even update his delivery address. These are not mandatory. They are the options. If he wants, he can apply it. Okay. So in such situations, you will be giving extends relationship. So extend relationship is from the optional to the original, from apply discount to the place order, right? So these are extends and includes are generally given between use case and the use case, right? Now let us see what are the various steps that we have to draw a use case diagram. The first thing you have to do is to identify the actors. Second, you have to identify the use cases. Once you are done with that, draw a system boundary. Inside that system boundary, place the use cases. To the left and right of the system boundary, place the actors and then start giving the relationships. Okay? And if needed, use includes and extends. So this is basically an example of a use case diagram for an ATM system. The rectangular box that you are seeing is the system boundary. The ovals are nothing but your use cases. The sticks that you can see here are the actors, and the lines that you are seeing are the association relationships. Okay, so we should make sure that whenever we have a use case, every use case should be having one input line and one output line. Now, what do you mean by this? Customer is asking for withdrawal, and the bank is going to check whether he is having enough amount in his account. Only then it is going to accept the withdrawal. Okay, input and the output. Customer is asking for checking the balance. Bank has to check in his account and display the balance. Customer is depositing the cash. Bank has to update the account details of the customer. Customer is transferring the funds. Bank should send to the appropriate account. Customer is changing the PIN. Bank has to update the PIN. So input and output. Okay, so these are associations that you have given, and you can see that all the use cases are inside the box. All the actors are outside the box. Now you can see an include and an extend relationship here. Include is used because withdrawal of the cash is including authenticate user. So if you have to be a valid user with a valid card and PIN, only then you will be able to withdraw the cash. Similarly, extends is there. Sometimes the user will check the balance and he can immediately withdraw the cash. This is optional. Okay, so here he can go for extends. So this is how you have to draw the use case diagram. Now I will show you how to draw the use case diagram using Star UML application. Now this is basically a Star UML application. To the right side on the top, you can see something called as model. Right click on the model, you will find the first option which is called as add diagram. Inside this add diagram, you have n number of diagrams. Select the use case diagram here. Once you select the use case diagram, to the left bottom, you will be having a toolbox. In this toolbox, you will get all the symbols that are related to your use case. The first thing we have to do is to create a system boundary. So for creating a system boundary, I will select an option called as use case subject. Click on that use case subject, come and paste it or drag it on this white area like this. Okay, now give a name here. So it is ATM system. So I write ATM and then I write system. This is the name of the project that you are developing. So ATM system. Now once I finish giving the system boundary, you can even decrease or increase the area as you want here. Okay. Now I select for the use case, the next option here. Click, paste it here. Okay. Give some name. Say suppose it is withdrawal. Withdrawal. So this is one use case. You can move the use case wherever you want here. So all the use cases must be inside the system boundary only. Now I will select actor, click here, come to this place, again click here. Okay, so this is how you will get the actor. Give a name for the actor. So in my example, it is customer. So I write customer here. Now I can move the actor wherever I want here. Right, now The next thing I have to do is to give the relationship. So I will select for association relationship. Now, to give the relationship, make sure you are placing your pointer on the actor and dragging it up to the use case. Okay, so this is how you have to give the relationship, right? Now say suppose I want to give includes. Let me say I have one more use case, which is saying authentication. Okay, now to do the withdrawal, I need to perform the authentication. So this is includes. Scroll down this toolbox, you will find one option called as include. Click on that include, draw an arrow mark from the URL use case to the authentication use case. Here comes the include. Okay, now select one more actor, put it this side to the right side and give it the name bank. Okay, place it properly and give association symbol between withdrawal and bank. This means customer is asking for withdrawal. Bank is checking his account and making sure he is getting the withdrawal. Now you can see that this include is overlapping this association. So drag this use case. So whenever we are giving relationships and all, we should make sure that they are not overlapping with each other. Right? So this is how we have to draw the use case diagram using Star UML. After this, you have to draw it for your respective project. Okay? Now, all of you are having sample SRS document with you. In sample SRS document, page number 36, you have something called as use case template. Right? So, once you finish drawing the use case diagram in your Star UML, take a screenshot and place it in your Word document just below 5.5. So after 5.5, you have to add annexure B. Under annexure B, the first diagram you will be drawing is your use case diagram. Below this use case diagram, you have to create a use case template. This is a table which talks about your use case diagram. So it consists of use case ID, which is some random number. Use case name will be your project title. Objective, why are you creating this use case diagram? Created by your names and role numbers. Okay, who are the actors? How did you start this system? Okay, you'll be writing about various user actions and system actions here. And then you'll write exceptional flows of user actions and system actions. That means if user does wrong, what is the action that I have to do? If system does something wrong, what is the action that I have to perform? Those are exceptional flows. So along with your use case diagram, you have to even complete this use case template and place it in your SRS document. Thank you.